everyone. It's Coach Fred here, and I'm going to be going over practice test 6, math non-calculator, question number 13 from the official College Board Study Guide. So we're at 13 on the non-calculator, and what are you supposed to notice here? You're supposed to notice the number. It's a little bit more challenging, so we want to make sure we really notice things about the question. So we were given 2x squared minus 4x equals t. In the equation above, t is a constant. We've talked about that, where that just means it's a number. So don't think of it as a variable. And if the equation has no real solutions, which of the following could be the value of t? So that no real solutions has to play in my mind. This doesn't ask you to solve it. This doesn't ask you to do anything but find the value of t. Well, because it's a quadratic, I'd really like it in standard form if I'm going to be dealing with solutions. Okay, so I'm going to bring that t over and get it set equal to 0, because then I might be able to do something more with it. So the fact that it has no real solutions tells me that this is a discriminant question. Discriminant. Okay, so if you forgot what the discriminant is and all the different things that can happen with the discriminant, I want you to go back to the 2 discriminant videos I have posted on my playlist. Because I go into detail on the types of questions that you could be asked and what the discriminant is. Okay, so I'm going to just do a quick review. The discriminant is part of the quadratic formula that tells me about the solutions to a quadratic. It is b squared minus 4ac. It's the part that's under the square root in the quadratic formula. And in order for it to have no real solutions, that value under the square root needs to be less than or equal to 0. Sorry, it has to be less than 0. Less than 0. All right, so I take my quadratic, I identify my a, my b, and c from the standard form. So let's remember ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0, and I plug them into the inequality. So my a is 2, my b is negative 4, and my c is negative t. All right, so I'm going to plug those right in. So b squared is going to give me 16. Minus 4 times 2 times negative t. And I want that to be less than 0. All right, I'm going to simplify. So that's 16 plus 8t is less than 0. So 8t is less than negative 16. And so t has to be less than negative 2. So t has to be less than negative 2. And it says, which of the following could be the value of t? Well, less than negative 2 can't be any of these, so my answer has to be A. All right, guys, hopefully that was helpful. Have a great day.